friends, welcome to my channel Creative Art. My name is Nilima and today we are going to do clay art on a glass bottle. Yes friends, after making the beautiful 3D clay wall decors, I have thought to do clay art on a glass bottle and in very easy and simple steps using the clay molding tools. So friends, please do watch the whole video to make this beautiful bottle decor yourself. And friends, please do subscribe my channel for more creative art painting videos and do press the bell icon to get notifications for each video I post every week. Friends, all the materials required to do clay art on glass bottle are mentioned in the description box below with their links from where you can also buy them as well as shown in the video. To get this image, to use it as a reference, please to click on the link www.creativearthome.com, which is my website. So enjoy this DIY, friends. Friends, let's quickly check out the materials which we are going to need for this DIY. First of all, we are going to need a glass bottle. You can also use a plastic bottle if you want to recycle it. You can actually use any kind of bottle, whichever you want to recycle. Secondly, to clean this glass bottle, I'm going to use clean mitt. You can also use alcohol. Thirdly, we are going to need Fabricryl pearl metallic color. I'm going to use pearl metallic gold 352. And the most important thing, we are going to use Fabrica molded. This is for 3D work of art, mural and decor. You can also buy this online or from shop. And if you don't get it, you can also use homemade air-dried clay. I have given the link of it in the description box below, from where you can watch the video and make homemade air-dry clay yourself. Next, we are going to need clay carving tools. Its link is also given in the description box. And these are the clay molding punches. Okay, I'm going to use this kind of flower and a leaf punch. You can use according to your choice. And other than that, we will require a roller and paintbrush to paint. Okay, so let's start now. As always friends, our first step is going to clean the surface on which we are going to do this DIY. So this is the glass bottle. I'm spraying some clean mitt and then spread it all around the glass bottle. Always you should be sure that there is no oil or dirt before you are starting the painting or any kind of DIY. Now using a clean cloth or napkin, you have to clean the whole surface. Okay, so the surface is clean now. Now our next step is friends, to mix the molded clay. You get resin and hardener in it. If you're going to do it for the first time, use a small quantity of clay. Cut it in equal parts and then mix it and keep the rest of the clay packed as it was. Now you have to mix both the clay, resin and base part. This is the easiest way to mix a clay. Now friends, our clay dough is ready. So I'm going to roll it and stretch it long. You can use some talcum powder on your base. Okay, after making this thin and long clay strings ready, you can either use a pencil to design it or you can directly place the clay strings as I'm going to do. I'll start from this place. For the most bottom, I'm going to select a thick piece of clay string, then place it on the Fabricol. Then I will continue the same till the top. So now I have done the vine part, and the vine starts from this part of bottom and then it has gone all over the bottle till the end, this part, okay. And now I'm going to start making the leaves, and this is how this part looks. Now friends, this is the next chunk of clay I have taken, and this is the roller. I'm going to flat it, apply some talcum powder on the base, then apply talcum powder on both the surfaces. Again, applying talcum powder, the top surface is smooth. Now, first of all, I'm going to show you how to do a leaf punch. Apply a little bit of talcum powder on the leaf punch. Then press it on the clay and then press the top button. Okay. Then lift it out. Here will be a leaf ready. I'm going to make all the leaves of this same shape and size. we are going to need a lot many leaves. Now I'm going to show you how I'm going to make the flowers, and for that I'm going to use this flower punch. Then remove the excess clay. You can reuse this once again. Cut out some more leaves using the leaf punch. Now friends, I'm going to use the small heart punch and cut out a few heart shapes. Now here friends, I'm going to show you the simplest way to make a small rose, okay? So these are the heart shapes which we have cut using the heart shape mold. So what you have to do is take one heart shape, press it flat a little bit, and then roll it from one side in this way. Then again take the second heart, press it with two fingers only, then roll it again on the same clay. You have to keep repeating these steps. Roll it on that clay. Press the heart and then just roll it on that clay. So friends, this is the rose we have got. In the same way, I have created few more roses. This is the smaller one of it. And now I'm going to start placing it on our bottle. This is our glass bottle. These are few roses and leaves which we are going to start placing on our bottle. So I have decided a center place from where I want to place them. Here I'll place leaf. So randomly select leaf. Shape them as you want to shape. Just a slight press on the clay. Whenever we are going to place a rose, I'm going to use this kind of sharp tool to poke it in the center and then press it till the end, okay? Till your rose settles well with the glue and the clay leaves. You have to hold it and then remove slightly. Okay, so this is how beautiful the rose looks. If you want to place one more, you can place one more, or just leave it in that way also. I'm going to place a smaller one in this side. So here comes a major question, friends, that you will ask whether the leaf and the flowers are completely dry. So let me tell you that the leaves and flowers are not completely dry. That's why I always make them in small quantities to place them when they are wet itself, and in that way only they stick well on the surface as well as with the fabricol. So this is the way you have to place roses on the strings. Let's move on to the next one. So this is the next place where I'm going to place the leaves. So I'll apply fabricol first, then shape the leaves in the way I want them to be. I'll press one edge of the leaf. Then I'm going to place small size rose over here. So apply a lot of fabricol on the center. Take the smaller size of the rose. Using the clay tool, press the rose till the full depth of it. Okay. You can also shape the rose because that's the only time you get to do that. And when it is settled down, slightly remove your clay tool. Okay, and let the rose get fixed up there. Now friends, we are going to put on the next leaf and flowers. So here I want to put them. I'll apply a little bit of fabricol first. Mold my leaf. I wanted to bring it up in this way. Just press them a little. Apply a little more of fabricol. And then I'm going to place small and beautiful rose over here. So in this way, I'm going to place the next rose, or else you can just keep on simply placing the leaves. I'll apply a little bit of fabricol and then place my leaf. Then join the leaf in a little bit to the stem. So yeah friends, this is the rose bush climb upwards with the leaves, and here again the rose, and here I'm again going to place few leaves, and this is again a flower, and the leaves and flower will keep on continuing till the top. So I'm going to complete it in this way and I will show you how does it looks. Okay, so now here friends, as you can see that I have finally completed my clay molding part, and this is how beautiful our bottle looks with the roses and leaf, and the clay has also got dried up. After each 2 to 3 bunch of leaves, I have made roses, whether there are 3 roses, single rose or double rose. And this is how the top of the bottle looks from here and here. Generally, the clay gets settled in 2 hours, but I keep it for at least 12 hours or over a night before painting. And now friends, we are going to start the coloring part using acrylic colors. I'll always advise you to use Camel Artist acrylic colors. I'm going to use 010 antique gold, parrot green color, olive green, brown, pink and red colors for coloring this bottle. Okay, now friends, first of all I'm going to start coloring using brown color, and I'm going to color the stems as brown. Now friends, after coloring the branches, we are going to start coloring the leaf, and for leaf, I use green color, and I make that green color using combination of these 3 colors. This is parrot green color, olive green and antique gold color. And by mixing this color, I get a green which absolutely looks like a natural green color. So friends, this is the green color we get by mixing these 3 colors. Now I'm going to start the painting part. Okay friends, in the same way I'm going to color all the leaves. So friends, after coloring all the leaves and branches, this is how our bottle looks. Now we are going to start coloring the roses, and for that I'm going to use pearl pink color and pearl light pink color. Okay, so these are the 2 colors I'm going to use for coloring the roses. And number 2 brush. And friends, after coloring the rose outer part with the dark pink, I'm going to use a light pink for the center and middle part and create a little bit of shading in this way. In the same way friends, we are going to color all the roses. In the outer part, I'm going to do the dark pink. And in the inner part, I'm going to use a light pink shade. So in the same way friends, I'm going to color all the roses present on this bottle, and then I will show you how does it looks. Okay, so here friends, my coloring part is finally completed, and this is how beautiful our bottle looks. I'll show you all the sides, and each flower looks equally beautiful. The string starts from this bottom and goes all around the bottle till the top, and this is how beautiful it looks. The neck of the bottle is really very beautiful, as I have placed so many flowers. So friends, this is how beautiful our bottle decor has come up. So friends, please do give it a try and tell me in the comments below how did you find this video friends, and if you did like this video friends, please do like, share and subscribe my channel. Thank you for watching.